Hello all. So this is the Mafell MA730 workstation. I love a mobile work surface, and this one always struck me as a nice design. Expensive though, at around £300 or $400 depending on where you get it. Now having made a little workbench for my l-boxxes, I thought it was high time to do one for the Systainers, taking Mafell's lead but saving a few quid along the way. As with all my grand designs, it starts from a janky drawing, having taken some measurements and a bench full of bits. I got a piece of black MDF melamine, a box of fittings, and a few 1 metre lengths of slot 8 40-40 profile. I'll start by sizing the melamine base. Clever though the Mafell one is, only its profile supports will fit in the Systainer. Mine I've tried to size so both base and supports will fit in the Systainer. Where you see I've got my cut lines taped up, that's only to show my markings. It's not to stop breakout, never found tape massively effective for that. But this saw has a score function, so it gives a beautiful clean cut anyways. To enable the base to attach to T-lock Systainers, I bought this set of feet on eBay. I'll leave a link in the description in case you want to do something similar. There's 5 pieces, including a little nubbin for the T-lock, 2 of the rear feet that hook into the box below, and 2 front feet. Cost a fiver this lot. Here I've tried to replicate the feet positions on the bottom of a T-lock box. I want this to be compatible with both the T-locks and classic Systainers I have, so I bought this piece of HDPM which I'll fashion some tabs out of for each corner. To mark this stuff, a simple marking gauge works great to score a line. With 4 little pieces cut, I pre-drilled everything to minimise pieces flailing about when they're fixed in place. I give each corner a pre-fit too to make sure everything is good. So with the feet in place, I can try it out on a box, and thankfully it seats in place just fine. So now I can move on to putting the little tab on for the T-lock. I've made a little standoff from 2 pieces of HDPE left over from earlier, so the tab can be fixed in a perfect spot. Even though I pre-drilled this, I'm still getting a small split in the MDF. Even if just for the sake of these 2 screws, if I were to do it again, I'd go with ply, I think. It's not enough to cause any issues for me here, but, you know, you want to do it right. I hand-screw on the tab so as not to destroy the plastic, and boom, it works a treat and keeps the base attached solid. So off camera, or rather standing in front of the camera so it's not worth including, I marked out the tab positions using a square going from the box below and just used a junior hacksaw to remove the unwanted material. The result is it will attach to a classic sys, this one in particular will be its actual box too. Being the heart of it all, there's still yet more work to do on the base. Here I've marked out for an 8mm slot on top and a 20mm slot on the bottom. These will house a large sliding T-nuts for the profile. Before I get on to routing those out, I'm cutting a 60mm hole in the centre. Bit of an afterthought, it'll give me something to grab hold of, removing the thing from the box when it's all done. The laminate gets an easing over, as did all the edges earlier, to try and minimise chipping as I work. Always feels very committal routing, doesn't it? I should probably say that I didn't really agonise over these slots, working out the minutiae. I just went with between and inside the feet, which seemed to give enough room for the profile to rest on and move around. With the routing done, I can finally move on to the profile. I cut four 350mm lengths. You'll see I'm using a bit of scrap underneath the profile. Seems to give a cleaner cut all round, I've found. Each piece of profile is going to have a protective strip of ply across the top, sacrificial if you like. I ripped down some 12mm scrap for the job. I made some recesses in the ply for my fancy bolts with a Forstner bit. They sit about 3mm shy of the ply surface tightened down. Below, the bolts get a T-nut to affix to the profile. These hinges are picked up after joining two profile pieces together, allowing them to articulate. They're supposed to mount profile parallel to each other, so they weren't really fit for the task, but I figured I could just cut these in half with a grinder and replace the pin with a small bolt. A bit more waggle than the original, but does the biz. Here I'm adding another sacrificial layer by way of some of the rubbery, foam acoustic deadening stuff you use under floor slabs. Self-adhesive and cheap, this'll work a treat. I only add some in 50mm, so I trim it with a Stanley blade. Besides having to get a new camera, one of the things holding up this build were these corner brackets. The nice black ones I've ordered from China are delayed as they're celebrating New Year holidays as I film. But in the meantime, in a bit of a hurry, I found this bag of 25 on Amazon for £18, with next day delivery for a bit extra. Nice. They have the little guide tabs on to locate in the profile, but as I'm to use them perpendicular to that, they get ground off. Just need to find something to use the other 20 odd brackets on now. For the cam levers, as you might have seen me do before, I'm just scrounging from El Cheapo bike seat post clamps. You'll notice here, before I put everything together, that I've drilled two 30mm holes in the centre of the slots. This is another afterthought that allow me to take the profile assemblies on and off without having to unscrew the T-nuts completely. You'll see what I mean in a minute. I set the brackets at a distance to allow me to fix them across as well as along the slots in the base. Gives me more options that way. With the bracket screwed in place on the profile, I can add the cam levers and T-nut and see if this thing actually goes together. For insert and removal, I need to fold the profile assembly, but the 30mm hole seemed to work an absolute treat. And there we are, all together and locked in place for the first time. Here I've got it in the X pattern as I clip it onto a classic sys. Locks in place nicely, but the old clip system is way less secure than the T-locks. I'll try and stick with T-locks to mount it on, I think. So yeah, dismantles in no time and packs away nicely in its box. In the next vid, I'll be making a profile roller for these Systainers. We'll look at this top in action a bit more, and I'll cover what this project cost. But at 12 minutes already, I think we'll leave it there for now. Any questions or comments, have at it below, and thanks for watching.